Alright, let us continue onward. We are here. Not there. Game, can you not do this? Like, what is this? We have discovered a fuel station. Yeah, okay, so what? Buddy? It doesn't do anything. Let's just scroll out, man. I wish there was some other way to do this, but there's no way to remap this, is there? I wish there were like a clean way to do this. There is, I want to know. I'm skipping time. Yeah, don't do that. H is home. G is global. That's Wild Dragon. Z, X doesn't do anything. C, V, and. Okay, we know what M does. Yeah, okay. We got nothing. Number keys? Yep, okay, I had it all. Nothing. Nothing does anything. Okay, well. Whatever. So we need the two oil barrels. Where exactly are these oil barrels? One's over there. The other one's not that bad, I remember. Okay. Well, Cousin Cletus, you gotta wait. Alright. Although. These are, they do say scout recommended. That makes sense. Cousin Cletus cannot have scout recommended, right? Because, oh, that's kind of crazy. How am I going to get down there? Get down there. Where's the other one? The other one's right there. Okay, you know what? Let's start with this. These guys say scout recommended, and honestly, I believe them. I honestly have no reason to disbelieve them, so. Might as well believe them at that point. Okay. You're really saying, I mean, it makes some sense, I suppose. Anyway, we'll purchase the International Taster, drive it over here. Not be that big of a deal. Because there's like three missions. There's even the mission where you have to pull that truck out of the mud. Right? Where technically we don't need it, but I would say we do. I would say we use it. We have not much choice, you know, in the whole matter. Okay. Gone driving. Okay, this is the way out. So yeah, this one at least we should be able to do. Cousin Cletus should not be that hard. That'll get a bunch of markers off the map. It's always fun. That is what we are here for. Getting rid of markers. Cleaning up the map. That's our primary purpose here. We shall do that. With dignity. Or whatever, I don't know. He'll do it. How I do it is up to me though. With dignity or without it. We keep pushing onward. There is a long way to go. Enter lock should help us get to where we're going. Okay. and we are out there. Keep it moving. Ah, so yes, I remember this spot. I'm wondering why there is this stuff here. I'm guessing because of Cousin Cletus. Now, let us activate the anchor, put on crane mode, see what we can do about this. Hopefully I can... Yep, okay, I can just get my winch over there. Alright, so it's actually quite easy. Alright, pull it up. Why is me trying to raise it actually taking it lower? Come on. Okay, there you go, and that'll give us more strength, able to raise it up. Finally. Alright. Okay. Back cargo, restore crane. Stop the engine. Excuse me, I said stop the engine. Alright, and then... I mean, honestly, it's like a... pretty simple... trip. Did you get me over there? You can do that. We'll have the other oil barrels, prevent another international incident of oil being spilled all over the damn place. Don't want that to happen. Anyway, keep it moving. Be a longish trip, but this should be an easy enough one, honestly. Which is more than I can say about the ones where they're saying we need a scout. That is going to be a lot tougher, but we can do it this way. We can try to do them with this vehicle, which is, as you can see, most definitely not a scout. Now, if we fail, can then purchase the International Pacer, like a nice scout, small scout vehicle, which has you know, a freaking truck engine, so it's a very powerful little scout. It should be able to go where we want it to go and have the strength to pull actual loads. Called the International Loadster for something, right? Not for nothing. Going on, I don't know. Phone rang, but apparently there was a notification sound, but there was no notification. Interesting. This is just the way I like my phone notifications. Cryptic. Okay. Well, that's one way to stop your vehicle. Activate the anchors, go into crane mode, please. train. You're gonna be nice and high up there. Then you're gonna start pulling. Hello, big old truck. Sitting there. Don't look at me. Just recovering some assets, as it were. These assets are of great value to the company. Especially because otherwise you're gonna have environmentalists coming over and being like, hey, why are you destroying the world? Which, I mean, they are. Company doesn't like that. Bad PR. So we're gonna drag it out and we're gonna take it back. Pull it back. Now raise it up. Try to as close as we can get it. Raise it up a bit more. Pull it a bit back. Okay, position it rightly. Lower it to the rightful place. Turn it so it orients correctly. Okay, sink it into place. Beautiful. Restore cane. Unpack back. We have both of the stuff that we need. Now about getting out of here. Yeah, I would recommend U-turning, because this place is not nice. Ho-ho! No. Not at all nice. Not even like a little bit. I would not recommend it. We'll just take our time. Go around and then get back to Uncle Cletus. Not Uncle Cletus. Cousin Cletus. On the road. There you go. Now, place doesn't exactly scream. Hey, let's U-turn. Doesn't look like it would be very easy. But it needs to be done. I would recommend we find a way to do it, and perhaps not on a giant slope. But I will literally die. You know what? What if we just go and drive it in reverse all the way back? Think we can do that? I wanted to try it. Seems like it would be stupid. But who knows? Maybe it'll work better than you think. Well, why would we not want to do that? For one, it's like impossible to see anything. Turning is reversed. Maybe I should just try and U-turn. Even if it is just... Oh my god. I think it's working though. I believe so. Yep, low gear differential lock. Does wonders. The auto, and then look at that. We turned. Took a while, but we did do it. Come on, the old bugger. Push on up the slope. Get these oil barrels over to the lighthouse keeper. way to the lighthouse keeper. Aren't we going to give this to Cletus? Cletus the lighthouse keeper? Explains why that freaking ship has overturned. Lighthouse. Oh, he is the lighthouse keeper. Okay. Why the hell does he live all the way over there, though? There's no lighthouse over there, is there? There isn't. Lighthouse is like, I mean, yeah, the hell of a commute. Tell you that. One hell of a damn commute. But whatever, I got your dirty ass oil barrels. Push them out of the off of the cliffs where you drop them. I don't know how you drop them into completely different places, but you managed it. So I guess congratulations. I got it back. Cleaned up your damn mess. I am expecting compensation. I'm expecting you to repair my cars for me. Probably won't do that, huh? Well, you gotta do it anyway. Can I put a car on my bed? Can I like pack it like cargo or some shit? That would be kind of cool. You're not going in there. I was like, for a second, I thought maybe you're gonna head in there. I was like, that doesn't look nice. That looks like a horrible little road where trucks gonna die. That is not somewhere we are going. Instead, we are running up here. Straight ahead. Come on. Come on. Low gear. Alright, come on. Once we're done with this, I gotta write an email as well. I don't necessarily have to do it, but I think it would be the right thing to do. You know, it would raise my chances of something good happening if I were to do that, and you know, I'm all about raising my chances. That's kind of what business is all about, right? Gotta take a chance and hope for the best. This road sucks, bro. This road absolutely sucks. One, garbage tier road, bro. Gotta give it the garbage tier rating. Considering how garbage it is. Do we really want to try to get that car right now with this vehicle? I don't think we want to. Last time I tried with a large vehicle, it toppled over. Because it was quite a tight place, you know, not a lot of space there to get your cool stuff done. Which is a problem, because I do like to get my cool stuff done. Moving. Keep on tugging. There you go. Oil barrels. Boom. Promoted level 16. Look at that. That was close. I was already on probation here. Serves me right for trusting a knuckle dragger like Cletus, right? I owe you big time. Now I can keep paying child support. What the hell? Child support. Alright, you wanna go get that observation done? Risky. Might be the right thing to do though. And I wish I could just get vehicles, but then I mean, if I could just get vehicles delivered here, that would basically make it a garage, which they do not offer here. All right, let's refuel. See if we can do some other quests. Recommended that we take a scout for those quests. Well, guess what? I don't have a scout. But at least one of them. It's about containers. Right? They have certain containers they wanna salvage, let's say. And you know, for that you're gonna need a crane. So maybe the next step in that mission is to actually get the containers. In which case, I think this vehicle is perfect for that. Kind of custom built for picking shit up, putting stuff to play, you know, in places. That's kind of what it is for. And it has done its job remarkably well, honestly. It's performed very well. Oh, I had read an email. Give me a second. Let's do that. All right, email sent. I'm hopeful I get a reply. I might just not, which is also fine. We'll see. But hey, I did my due diligence. I sent an email. Whatever. Can't do much more than that now, can I? Alright. Oh my god, the mud. Well, to be honest, this area is not going to be easy, right? It's the final zone of Michigan. Which is the first area, but I'm guessing like all areas are equally difficult. That would make sense. Game about driving, so no. I'm expecting, and they also did mention that, oh, why don't you do the levels in any order? I mean, they pushed me to Alaska at the end of the tutorial, right? So you know, I'm guessing it doesn't really matter which one you do first. You can do whatever you want. So you know, I am hopeful that this is the hardest it gets. Well, you know, relatively. So I'm sure there are certain missions where the difficulty is higher. Obviously, it's gonna happen. But you know what I mean. It doesn't have to be. I mean, mostly, this is the hardest. You know. You get it. Like, I'm sure there are like a couple of cases which might be like way harder than this, but mostly, like, the final areas of places should be, I think, like approximately this difficulty. In any case, Forged by the Sea is what I want to do right now. So, this will be a tight thing, but. And those crates look like they're a lot bigger. Right? They don't look like they are very small. Maybe they don't really expect me to pick it up at all. But I mean, in that case, then who's gonna pick it up? They gotta get delivered. Like, I mean, maybe you all are gonna go there and crack them open and, like, take whatever you need from them. That could be something that they do. Possibly, which would make sense. Hell yeah, I avoided the kill zone. I think. Yeah, I did. Alright, I'm out of there. Yo, this is so bright, man. It's so bright. This is insanely bright. It is crazy. Cousin Cletus is there, but Cousin Cletus' problems have been solved already. It's not why we are here. Try and avoid the main roads. Sometimes you have no choice to realize how much of a problem the main roads really are. Alright, now unfortunately, oh, but try to use this. Yeah, we need to actually freaking latch onto this, which we cannot do. Okay, that means we can't use it. It is crazy, by the way, that you can just fuel, you can just use. By even getting close to it, you can just refuel, no problem. Vehicle, tank, whatever, doesn't matter. But repair? No, no, no. You gotta actually be attached to the thing. Like, it's literally, it's got like a door and everything, right? It's an independent freaking module you just leave around and use it to repair stuff. Yeah, it's got wheels, but basically a mobile repair shop. So, let me use it to repair my shit. Okay? Let it do what it was designed to do. Now, these missions were not designed to be done with this kind of vehicle. I'm gonna do it anyway. Because I don't give a flying F. Yep, you're right. A flying fart. That's what I meant. Anyway, keep driving. It should not be that hard, especially with low gear differential lock. Break, break it. Bro. Just bloody break the damn thing. No biggie, just break it. It's wood. Wood, that's what it's there for. It is wood. He's a wood man. Yo! Not just some containers, it's the whole damn ship. It goes without saying that the contents of those crates are of purely sentimental value. Still, if anyone asks, I'd appreciate if a little enterprise would go unmentioned, if you get my meaning. Yes, they're stealing the crates. Did not realize there was an actual full thing here. I also didn't realize we actually just did it. Alright. Well, I mean, if you were able to just do that, no reason why we can't just do this too. You know, get the observation done. What is this mission about, really? Plant of the weather. You're probably tired of hearing how bad the weather's been, but let's be honest, it's also feathered your nest, maybe a lot of money. One of our observation points went silent in the last storm. Can you head out there and see if it's okay? I can do that. Go check out your observation tower. There's damage to it or something. Maybe I'm speaking too early and the game will teach me a lesson. But you don't need a scout vehicle for this. Like, yeah, it's a little bumpy. You can figure it out. Like, this place, that was kinda hell. We're gonna avoid that massive hole there. There you go, once you know how to do that though. You go around and then you're back at the start. We'll be heading up to where the scout tower was. Or we get an achievement for finding all the scouting towers in Michigan? Probably give me an achievement for finding all the scouting towers in the game. But I'm thinking the game is probably considered Michigan and Alaska, right? The rest were added as DLC. Man, I would buy the other DLCs. They're probably like insanely expensive though, right? Game is on Game Pass, but the DLCs are not. I think it's kind of annoying, if I'm being honest. Like, if the game is available, like, that's the one kind of annoying thing about Game Pass that I feel. Game selection is fine. Problem is, they're not all like the complete versions, you know? Which that is also at the ground level is fine, you know? Sure, okay, you're not gonna give me all the complete versions for free on Game Pass. Because I'm paying for Game Pass, whatever. Regional pricing, man. Just implement regional pricing. Low gear, different lock. Yeah, this is bad. We're too thin. Sorry, we're too thick. The pass is too thin. Try and just shove through, but. Tires get stuck. And our winches aren't really helping much. Give her all she's got. No, it's not gonna help. Alright, well. We tried. For this one, you do definitely need a scout. We'll drive one over here eventually. Come on, buddy. What's the problem? Oh no. Oh, thank God. Okay. Well, that was absolute shite. We're gonna need a scout vehicle to get that shit done. But now we just get out of here. I guess we'll try and get that scout truck out of the mud there. And then we'll have to, you know, send a scout truck up to get the deal with whatever are there. And there are issues, I'll tell you that much. Good pit going down, we cannot pit going up. Now they're kind of asking for a lot, huh? They want a truck with a crane, they want a truck with a high jack. I guess they don't really need a... Yeah, no, but they need a crane and a jack, for sure. Carry this stuff. Pick up stuff. They need a crane from which you can attach trailers. So like this one right here, not good enough. I guess you could have a bed, be fine, probably. Anyway, this vehicle has done a lot for us. If it dies at this point, I will not be overly sad. I'll be a bit sad, of course, but it does help us accomplish a lot of missions. If it needs a bit of R&R, I will be gladly giving it to, allowing it to have that, you know. It has done rather well up until now, so. Give it a bit more. Okay, so the other one, leave the beaten track, go explore. Shut up, man. Mud wrestling, we're doing that. Silent observer, can't do that. Another mud wrestling, race of the rain is done. So yeah, it's only these and then this one. Buildings, the observation point, log station, gateway, gateway, fuel station. Okay. And then if I say this, which will dam area. These do exist. So medium logs to the worker, medium logs to the lighthouse keeper, medium logs to the farm. We don't get medium logs here though, which is the worst part. A farm and several residences. A bit of logs. You gotta help them. There are logs at the timber station, but they have to be delivered. What are you talking about? The wooden planks. There's long logs here. There's no medium logs. Why not? Then we have super order, Smithville Dam, island rig, black. Okay, so we do have stuff for the port. Metal beams and concrete slabs. Can't get them here. Although metal beams, you do have some lying around. Concrete slabs too. I think we have them both here. And then cement for every single place. Where the hell do we get cement from? And then oversized cargo. Smithville Dam. I think we have oversized cargo. Cargo from the ships. The ship is probably right there. Okay. We're getting there. Too much wrestling. To get to this spot here. How much fuel I got? 2/3 of it. Eh, should be fine. They don't burn that much fuel anyway. Now, I do not recommend going that way. That's dumb. Why, you know why it's dumb? Because I tried it already. Instead, to go over the bridge that we built. Then enter from this side, because we know that all of this is a traversable area. However horrible it is, it does work at least, so that's good. Cross that, head up here, and now our worst nightmare is this little area here of hell. There's the lighthouse keeper's lighthouse. Okay, so we're low gear differential locking out of here. Okay, now we can auto it. Not for long probably, because this water is gonna be hell once again. Unless they're slowing down. I have not stopped though. Look at that. Able to make it. I'm fine at every single one of these. But like, if you keep half our tires off road, get a lot better traction. Try and stay near the borders of the road. Better for the old vehicle traction, you know. Alright, onto the road. My fuel tank took damage. You can go straight to hell. Do not pass go. Okay, we should have our bridge coming up. Our abridged version. There you go. this is the turn, this is the turn. If I can get there, that'll be great. But if not, I mean, that's why we are purchasing an international pacer. Right? That should help us out with that. What the pacer is for. Ah, I turned here. Can you see? All the lines that I left. Low gear differential lock allows us to pass by, no problem. It is a mess in here though. Yikes, very messy. But here we are up at the top where we rescued that oil battle. Sometimes it's quite hard to follow the path, but even the path seems to, like, you know, disappear, as it does tend to do. It isn't a very used path, you see. But I must use it if I am to get to those idiots' vehicle that they have lost all the way out in the wilderness. They want it back and they want it repaired. They are willing to pay for it, so. You know, a fool and his money are soon parted and all that. So we do have to provide a service for that, which is getting their vehicle straight out of the mud. Hey, auto mode. Okay, it's a lot nicer. Let's have a look at the way forward, shall we? If only this tree didn't exist in the way, it'd be a lot nicer. As you can tell, sometimes I wish I did have a vehicle with like a saw on it. Just cut down these annoying. Oh my god. It is indeed a very tight setup. Okay, like too tight, honestly. Things you have to do. Get where you want to go, it's crazy. This area is not made for this kind of a truck, huh? Well, I got it in there. Oh. Spoke to Sue. No! Well, shit. I was almost there too. Alright, we recovered it. It was gonna happen at some point anyway, we knew that. Okay, what we need right now. Truck, stop. Stop that. Scout. An international lodestar. It's a very expensive scout. But I mean, that's why we like this bad boy. Purchase and deploy. It looks, I mean, it is just a mini truck, is what it is. Oh, we even have the 200T, a modification of the popular engine supporting increased power output, reliability, and acceleration potential at cost of fuel efficiency. Yep, okay. I don't think we need an off-road. I would love high. Okay, 35-inch. We'll have to do. Autonomous high power. Advanced scout winch setup featuring both an extended length and a more powerful motor almost bridges the gap between scout winches and heavier truck-oriented setups. Give me. Okay, we can't have both. Shit. Well, I tried. We get a this thing. Pickup chassis add-on. A pickup-style chassis variant. Service cab. Parts used to make repairs. We can put a... What the hell? A loading crane on this bad boy. Holy. Front side, yep. Give me some angled beacons. Flasher bar. Roof fog lights. Beacons and fog lights. Here you get the beacon. Heavy duty pipe. Angled. Defender. Hinged. Get a defender. Caged beacon. Two pin. Side chrome parking lights. We like lights. Twin horn as well. External horn. Searchlight. Yeah, searchlights look cool as hell. External horns. Can't put the two square beacons and all. Okay, it's sad. And then, oh, you gotta love the red rims, bro. Can't say no to the red rims, man. Okay, so. What does the autonomous look like? Just to say they all look the same. Okay, well, good to know. Pickup, repair parts, spare wheel, and fuel tanks. Like, it's gonna use it for a bit of repairs. Nah, we'll just leave. So, I mean, this is a very stupid looking vehicle. It's basically like a chopped off truck, man. Like, it is a truck. I mean, they even say it's basically a truck, right? This is crazy, though. Now, it does have a very, very powerful... I mean, it has a truck engine. So, but it's a tiny-ass vehicle, probably very light. I can't believe it has a freaking crane on it. I mean, it makes sense, right? Why couldn't it have a crane on it? Also, it has AW differential lock always on, which is also insane. It putters along, no problem, bro. This might be my new. This might be an actual scout vehicle I really want. A crane on it, bro. That's crazy. Because, like, with a crane on it as well, now you can use it to do a lot of crazy shit. You could, I mean, you probably would like to attach a scout trailer with the crane, and that would be insane. Or we could use this in conjunction with other larger vehicles. Horns. They have all these lights in the front and all that. Looks very cool. Gotta say, it's a right dapper looking car. And I mean, obviously, all my vehicles have beacons on them. Just so people know that I'm important, you know? You can turn them on. I'm going in for a rescue. It isn't a particularly fast vehicle. Then again, it isn't made to be particularly fast, I believe. Although, I mean, in the mud, it is, but like, extremely fast. It does its job extremely well. Yes, I think if we can get this vehicle over there, this should be able to easily pull that truck out of the mud, get it to where it needs to go, and also do the other mission, which is to get to the top of that, the point. Oh, and with always on AWD differential lock, this freaking road will be like no problem. This road should be like any other. Now, I do wish we had a bigger fuel tank, because I think 130 is still larger than any other Scout. I mean, it has like almost full-size proper truck. No. I mean, it has like a truck body too at the back. Like this is more, it can't have a bed. It's the only real problem. If it were a little bigger, and I could fit like a single unit of cargo on there, that would make it kind of overpowered though, huh? The amount of power it can deliver is great, you know? Again, it makes absolutely perfect sense. You put a truck engine, even though it's not a very powerful truck engine, it's a pretty good one, in like an actually like a tiny ass vehicle. Yeah, you'll get insane amounts of power from that. Now, I do wish we had raised suspension. You can get some beautiful huge tires, but they're big enough, they work. And the bigger tires are in Michigan, Alaska, so the race suspension for this, sorry, is in Michigan, Alaska. And we haven't gotten there yet. Not Michigan, Alaska, I'm talking about Alaska, Alaska. Michigan, by the way, not in Alaska. The great US of A. And Alaska is also there. Okay. It does keep puttering along, no problem. Come what may, and with the advanced winch, which will now be a standard on all vehicles I own, survivability should be even higher. I do wish we could have advanced and autonomous at the same time, because then we could, like, you know, be prepared for anything. Now, I do understand how that could be a little overpowered. Just a teeny tiny bit. Whatever. Should be fine. Be able to go. Look at that. We got there a lot faster than before. Makes a lot of sense considering how uncaring this vehicle is for any sort of bump on the road or whatever, dirt, whatever you want to call it. This bad boy does not care. He just keeps on driving, no matter what you throw at it. Okay. Well, some suspension damage was to be expected, I suppose. But it should be smooth sailing from here on out. And once we're done with these, we have the last couple of things that need to be done. Don't forget, there is also another time trial thing in the Iron Lake area that we have not done. Needs to be done. Other than that, we will be done with all available like missions and stuff, quests, whatever you want to call them. In all of Michigan, I mean, all the quests are done. There'll be one time trial left after we're done with the two that are over in this area. But entire traversal is done. Jackknife accidents occur. I will never know. I will never know why jackknife accidents occur. Which is why they will keep occurring. I won't even know why they are occurring. Or if they are occurring. I don't even know what they are. Never will. Alright. Well. Let's get going. All the going is good. Start with objective number one, numero uno. Get this observation done. Would be the easier. Well, I'd say it should be easier. The road is kind of narrow. You should fit. You know? Old baby truck should fit in there. Same problem with the other area we need to go to. But once again, mini baby truck should fit. Mini baby truck should have no problems with any of these things. Okay, bump it up. Going. Yo, I mean, even the mud. I mean, we'll run into some harder mud spots soon. Yo, okay. This is what I miss. This is what I mean when I say I want my vehicles to turn. This is what I mean. Hell yeah, bro. Yo, okay. This is even better than my scout trucks. My off-road trucks. This is. Look at this. This is why you love a scout. Look at this. It does not. He loves it. It does not care about any sort of mud. Okay, it's just going through. Okay, well, you get a bit stuck here. Just low gear and we'll get through. Now, the problem is our tires are a bit too small for this thing. I think with the raised suspension and bigger tires, this should not be a problem. I think it's coming up too high. I think it's causing resistance with my actual truck body. Just causing a bit of a slowdown. I think if that problem can be solved with higher suspension, bigger tires, that would do it. But then again, we don't have higher suspension. That problem will persist for a bit. Fortunate as it may be, that is the reality of the situation. Do not fall over, I swear to God. You fall over. The hell are you stuck on? Okay, time to try out this insanely good winch. It's freaking tiny, bro. It worked. But it is like insanely tiny. Like any sort of mud is even the slightest bit deep causes problems. The tires are too small. It's the simple reality, whether you like it or not. It's just the tires are way too small. We need the bigger tires to be able to deal with the deeper mud. For that, we need race suspension. We need it. Okay, I mean, taking damage straight to the fuel tank is bad. Fuel tank damage is some of the worst damage. Fuel tank is damaged. That means, okay, come on. Why did I buy this freaking expensive ass, defending, what the hell are they even called? Front thing that you put on the top, on the car? Bumper? There you go. Why did I buy this big ass bumper? I'm not expecting the car to hit something. I'm expecting it to hit something, and I'm expecting the car to still be fine. Because I put the expensive bumper on there. Low gear me, get me through. I understand that there is water here. I don't care. You have AWD, you have differential lock, deal with it. Always with this freaking log. Here you go, it's broken. That's what you always need to do, drive over them so they break. Alright. So, my big boys could not deal with this. Time for you to do it. It has some serious strength to it, you can tell. What the frick is this? Kind of a dumbass hole is that? Stuck on some frickin' these rocks, man, real annoying. And I don't mean the big ones. The big ones, I mean, you can deal with those. But like the tiny ones are also very annoying. Go, we made it. Again, annoying as well, rocks. That's why we need higher suspension. There's no way like my big truck could have made it around these corners and shit. Do you see how horrible the climb is? Mud time. Where the hell is your tower? There is no tower here. Even if there was, how did you fucking build it? I'm stuck on another damn rock. You know, I'm getting stuck on this fucking rock every time. Can I get like a rock crane? Bro! Who the... Which asshole developer put this rock here, knowing full well Screw you, I don't care which developer put it here. I did it. I don't care what rocks you throw at me. Thank God. I'm glad to hear that the observation point's okay. That would have been a nightmare to fix with this terrible weather. Hey, you might want to enjoy the view from the ridge out there before the weather gets bad again. Your observation point? I mean, it's a good... I thought there would be like a tower or something up here though. There is like literally freaking nothing. So the hell to get up here. To be fair, it was hell because I had no raised suspension. I think if I had raised suspension on this vehicle, it would have made it a bit easier, I suppose, but whatever, I don't have that. I have to deal with. Now, my only request that this vehicle be allowed to get to the fuel station. We'll end it after that, okay? It's just, if it doesn't get to the fuel station, I would rather start the next episode with me driving all the way back here rather than end it on top. Then end up having to drive all the way back after failing to get down or not being able to reach the fuel station or whatever. Stop it! Why did I buy this bumper? Bro! Cannot take so much damage. And the scout winch, the super scout winch, whatever the hell it's called that we have, is garbage. Not very good, man. Alright. Bloody hell. Okay, just low gear it. At least we'll use less fuel. Takes as long as it takes. Again, I think bigger tires will solve this, but maybe it won't, you know? Maybe this is just supremely annoying mud that just does not get solved easily. I mean, my off-road truck kind of solves it easily though, right? Yeah, see, with rear suspension, so that's the real reason why you want rear suspension. Because you don't want big ass rocks underneath you. They're getting like, fuck off, hitting the chassis of your vehicle, and then you basically being stuck because there's rocks stuck under there. With raised suspension, you're more likely to just go over them, especially if you have even bigger tires, so you're just above the ground more. Also, I'm hoping it also does help with mud. Right? It's like you're very low on fuel. I'm well aware of that fact. Believe you me, I am working on it. Oh, you know, is it this? Is it the corner of this thing that's causing the problem? Bro, you crazy? Just winch onto that. the winch is supposed to be super strong. I don't know if I believe that, considering it would really do much for me right there, but I mean, it got me out, but I was sort of expecting more. Although, to be fair, this is a very heavy vehicle, right? Anyway, it says gas that way. I need gas. Oh my god, are you really stuck again? We do not have time for this. Don't have the time. Well, really, we don't have the fuel. We're getting stuck like this. We need to get to this fuel station. Okay, over the bridge. Let's go. Here, we're going full speed. Now, be smart. We avoid this part of the road. We drive halfway off. There you go. Sprint over these rocks a little bit. There's the gas station. Alright, 15 liters to spare. Triumphant. Fill up on fuel. Alright, so now, next time we gotta go do this mud wrestling mission. We'll plan it out next time. But yeah, once we're done with that, I mean, look at this, that's it. It's mud wrestling. That's the only task. And even if I look at this, at the map, I can. Yep, do mud wrestling. And then a race with the rim, that's already done. That's it. It's, we only got mud wrestling delivered to the worker's house. Then we can start with out with the old next time. Anyway, I'll see you then.